So you're ready to create your first visualization in Datawrapper and might be wondering, where do I start? Do not worry, because I got you covered. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can play around with different chart types in Datawrapper and also how to create a line chart with custom colors, annotations, and a strong message. And by the end of this video, you're going to be able to create something like this. So let's get started. So before you can import the data into Datawrapper, you need to prepare it. For a line chart, your dataset needs to have the following structure. One column with the dates that will be plotted on the horizontal axis, and one or more columns with the values, that is, for each line that will be visualized. The data that we're going to use in this video shows monthly market share values for different web browsers. Whenever your data is ready to be imported into Datawrapper, you can head over to app.datawrapper.de, click on Create New, and select Chart. This will bring you to step one, upload your data. Here, you can copy and paste your data in this text box. You can also upload a CSV file or an Excel file and choose the sheet that you want to import or even link to live data. In this tutorial, we'll just copy and paste the data into this text box. Once you got your data into Datawrapper, you'll click on Proceed in the lower left corner to check it in the next step. Once you land on the Check and Describe step, you'll see that Datawrapper placed your data in a tabular form and has interpreted each column according to the values in them. In green, you'll see the dates. In blue, the columns with numerical values. Had you had text, that would have been shown in black. And of course, if you see any red cells, it means that there's an error in the data that needs to be fixed. Click on Proceed, and Datawrapper will take you to the next step, Visualize. Once you land on the Visualize step on the right side of the screen, you're always going to see a preview of the visualization that will automatically update as you customize it using all of the different options that you see on the left side of the screen. Visualize has four different tabs: Chart Type, Refine, Annotate, and Layout. In the first tab, Chart Type, you can test which visualization type will work best for the data. For these data, we need a chart type that shows trends and developments over time well. Let's try an area chart. Or a multiple lines chart. Both chart types don't seem ideal, because we kind of lose the direct comparison between Google Chrome and Internet Explorer. So let's go back to the line chart. If you click on Proceed, you'll get to the Refine tab, where you're going to be able to customize your line chart with all the options that you see on the left side. You can expect these options to be different depending on the chart type that you're working with. For example, the option for customizing scatter plots or stacked column charts or multiple donut charts will be different from the line chart ones. Let's go over a few of the options to improve this chart. The development of Google Chrome and Internet Explorer shares are the most important aspect here, so let's give them a more distinct look and width. Let's also de-emphasize the rest of the lines by giving them a gray color and a thinner line. Tooltips are also turned on by default to allow our readers access the underlying data. We can change the date format of our tooltips to show months instead of days. If you click on Proceed, you'll then move on to the next tab, Annotate. Here, you can add more information to the chart to guide your readers through the story that you want to tell. You can add a title, a description, some notes that will be displayed above or below the chart. You can also add annotations on the visualizations directly. For example, you can add a text annotation to highlight the point in time where Google Chrome reached 50% of the market share. To do so, you can click on Add Text Annotation and place it by clicking on the spot where you want the text to show on the chart. You'll be able to further customize this text annotation using any of the options from the panel that will open on the left side of the screen. An important part of Datawrapper is that it allows you not only to show the data, but also to contextualize it for your readers, for which text annotations are super important. If you want to highlight ranges in Datawrapper, click on Add Range Highlight, and then click and drag on your chart. You will visually show the area up to the 50% mark to make it even clearer for readers. If you click on Proceed, you'll then get to the Layout tab. Here, for example, you can enable the dark mode option so that if you embed your line chart on a website that has a dark mode option, it will automatically switch to dark mode for better readability. Or you can also add social media share buttons to your chart as well. The last step is the Publish and Embed step. Up to this point, the chart you created is private. That means that only you, the person who created the chart, has access to it. There are two different ways to get your chart out of Datawrapper and into publication. The best way is to click on Publish Now, and right after, Datawrapper will share with you a link to the visualization so that you can share it with others, and also an interactive embed code so that you can embed the chart in a website. You can also download the chart as an image for use in social media or presentations, or as part of Datawrapper paid plans, as an SVG or PDF vector files to use in printed publications. And that's it! Congratulations! You just created, customized, and published your first line chart in Datawrapper. I hope you found this video helpful and that you're excited to start creating more line charts in Datawrapper. Thanks for watching and happy charting!